My name is Jahenns Manigat. I'm from Ottawa, Ontario, and I play for the Fraser Valley Bandits. This is my first summer playing, but I have a good relationship with the head coach. He's known me since I was like 14, 15 years old. So when he asked me to play, kind of made it an easy decision for me to play for him.
Yeah, I've known Jahenns since he was playing high school basketball in Hamilton. So I've always kind of been a fan of his game. And then coincidentally, 2 years ago when I was recruiting imports, I was looking at a player who Jahenns was actually playing with. And I immediately recognized him. I immediately knew who it was. So when I got a chance to coach in Canada, he was high on my list of players that I wanted on my team. So yeah, known him for a long time, been a fan of his game for a long time, and happy now to be able to be working with him.
I haven't played serious basketball in Canada since maybe high school. So it's been a while. After that, I went to the States for 4 years of college and 6 years playing pro now. So I think it's going to be a neat experience. I'm really looking forward to it. There's a lot of guys in this tournament that I've played with or against growing up, and to see those familiar faces, to see everybody doing well, it's neat. This is a good chance for us to all reconnect and also compete against each other and push each other and get the best out of each other. And this is really good for Canadian basketball. Was like a band geek legit when I was a kid growing up. My parents just always wanted me to be in extracurricular activities, myself and my sister and my two older brothers. So we all played music at some point in our lives, and I ended up really liking it. Obviously started with piano, and then when I got to middle school, I joined a band and I learned how to play clarinet and trumpet. And before you know it, I was doing double French horn and various other instruments as well. And I did that all the way up till 10th grade, and then I really started to focus on basketball. And my parents just wanted us to be, you know, out of the streets doing something after school, you know. So it started with music, and then it turned into sports with soccer and volleyball, and then eventually basketball. So being the youngest of four, I got to see them play in high school growing up, and I just enjoyed watching them play so much that I wanted to do it as well. So when I picked up a basketball, it was just kind of a foregone conclusion that that's what I was going to end up doing. So we were having a up and down season in Hungary, and the last 7 games that we were able to play, we really figured things out. We went on a 7-game winning streak, and we had a game on a Wednesday night, and that was the first time that they announced that we wouldn't play with fans. And on the Friday morning practice, our GM comes and he lets us know that the league is going to vote whether or not they're going to keep going due to the growing threat of the coronavirus. Little did we know how big of an issue it was. By that upcoming Tuesday, the league had been officially canceled. And by that Friday, I was on a flight back to Canada. It was very scary because we didn't know what we were dealing with. And I think even to this day, we still don't really know what we're dealing with. But yeah, fortunately for me, it all kind of worked out. And I'm glad I got back to Canada safe and sound. That's what this summer has kind of helped me do, is to sit down and spend some more time with family. Times that maybe I've taken for granted before, I definitely haven't taken it for granted this summer. We've all kind of been together since the beginning of this quarantine season, and it's meant a lot to me. You know, I've had a chance to do stuff with them that I haven't been able to do in years. Just things like a simple barbecue, hanging out in the house, going golfing. Stuff like that we haven't done in a really, really long time because life just keeps pulling us apart. But COVID-19 has kind of forced us to rekindle that family bond that I think we just kind of all took for granted a little bit. But I know looking forward, I'm definitely not going to do that ever again.
There it is.
That's my best one.
It's a good hit.
What are you using to get there?
A 7.
A 7?
Yeah, it's about 120 from here apparently.
So the 7 would be probably 150. I'm gonna use my pitching wedge to get there.
You're stronger than me though.
You heard that, right?
That's gonna make the edit.
Just being in the same league and being able to share this experience with them, I think it'll be exciting. I mean, you get to see your brothers like perform face to face. The last time I saw him play, in person would have been when he played in the NCAA tournament in North Carolina. And back then I was playing professionally. And so it's kind of crazy to see it come full circle. There's nothing I'm more proud of in my life in terms of being able to see my brother now entering almost his seventh season as a professional basketball player. And for me, who's played 4 years, to see him go even further and to continue to make this a career, and now I'm coaching, and just, we're really proud of it. I'm really proud of him. It's coming back full circle, and I'm just happy to be a part of it. Two good things about COVID: lots of golf, and this is the most I've seen this guy since high school.
First, I'm incredibly proud of Willie. He's put in so much work to put himself in this situation, and you know, he's one of the guys that really influenced me to start playing basketball and to really take it seriously. He's been a loving brother to me, a very helpful brother to me. To this day, I still take his advice on a lot of things, and now he's on the Niagara coaching staff during the CEBL series, so it's going to be fun to play against him as well.